The Amazon jungle, 1877. My little tour guide had come down with a bad case of the death, and I was on my last pinch of snuff when all of a sudden I looked out of the clearing and I saw the leopard. And I creeped up very slowly. You know, it was drinking from a pond, just as you or I may drink from a pond. And I raised my rifle, and I fired, making sure I was the last thing it had ever seen.
I say, Chauncey, you have quite the prolific propensity for murder. I dare say that there is no one better. Do you agree, Erickson?
Yes, I concur, although we may want to keep it down or else we might scare away our prey.
Oh, Sniff Schnapp, Erickson! You're just upset because you're the lowliest adventurer of the three of us! Oh, how about you regale us with your tales in the Arctic, Sir Gregory?
Oh, the frozen Arctic. It is the largest desert in the world, you know.
I've been to the desert.
Yeah, we've all been to the desert, Erickson.
There I was, 2 years into a four-week expedition. The captain and my crew at this time was just three dogs, because I had killed the rest of the men for food, but not the dogs, so they respected me, unlike Erickson.
Dogs respect me? Erickson, can you shut the fuck up?
The sun had not risen for as many 6 months, so naturally at this point I was blind as bat, so therefore I developed skills of echolocation. I was communicating with whales deep below the ice when I convinced one of them to meet me at the surface. When he breached, I whispered in his ear, I have bested you, blubber monster, and I slit his throat and dragged him up onto the land, and then me and the dogs killed some little fish and ate those.
Why did you kill the whale, then?
Well, to prove that I was a man.
But that's wasteful.
Erickson, I dare say you're going to scare away the lions with your doubtful yelling.
What? You're yelling too?
Yes, but I'm yelling with pride. They are lions, Erickson. They are attracted to pride.
They're not attracted to pride. They only live in them.
We understand, Erickson, how difficult it must be having never killed anything.
What? You know, I dare say the most elusive thing we can hunt is little Erickson's manhood.
No!
I killed a mammoth!
Oh, bullshit.
No, I did. I killed it. The last mammoth.
Well, then where is it?
It's in space.
Space?
Yes.
Why is it in space, Erickson?
Okay, so the aliens called me up, and I no, I had met them before, and they gave me this thing called a cell phone. You see, it's kind of like a phone, which is kind of like yelling really loud. It's gonna be big. Anyway, aliens, they called me up, and they're like, yo, Erickson, we totally need that mammoth for our intergalactic museum. Also, please have sex with our alien wives.
And did you do it?
Yes, they had big dicks.
Can't you see? Erickson's taking us for a fool. There's nothing in space but God hiding behind the moon.
Yes, sir. I killed the last mammoth at my bar mitzvah.
You know what, Gregory? I dare say little Erickson might make the perfect lion mate.
He could do, Chauncey. But there is one thing that I've always wanted to hunt.
Oh.
A lemur?
Okay, well, I'll tell you what, Erickson. Since I like you, I'm gonna give you a 10-pace head start. Or, I'm gonna let you call down the little alien friend and see if we can help you. Erickson, it's me!